He had yielded at last, but his condition was that Frank Littlewood should use his time as his private secretary to get a good general idea of his business, and then be transferred to one of his companies where he would have to sink or swim. Frank Littlewood's position was therefore really a temporary one, and his salary, too, was not high. Sir Robert was not a hard man, Miss Pritt insisted, but he had his own conception of things, and he prided himself on the way he stuck to his principles. Miss Pritt did not conceal the fact that Sir Robert disliked his nephew. This dislike was fully reciprocated. But she also suspected that he could really not forgive himself for having yielded to his wife and sister and taken somebody into his private office who had a claim on him other than a purely business one. "But what was Frank Littlewood's business before he entered his uncle's employment?" Mooney asked. Miss Pritt was not sure, but she believed he had worked on a newspaper for some years. He was rather proud of being a journalist, and he was extreme in his views on politics. That was, of course, a further complication, but the real trouble between uncle and nephew started about a year ago when Sir Robert made the discovery that Frank Littlewood had gone through one of the private files in his office without his authority. Sir Robert had been away at that time, and Frank Littlewood, of course, had no business to do it. As a matter of fact, the file was usually kept locked up, and it was partly due to her own negligence, Miss Pritt regretfully confessed, that the thing had happened. Still, that did not excuse Littlewood, who, in general, seemed to have taken his uncle's rather vague promise to let him get a general hang of his business a little too literally, and, Miss Pritt thought, not without some ulterior motive, as was subsequently proved. "Do you mean," Mooney interposed, "that Frank Littlewood was trying to find something which he could later use to obtain a hold over his uncle?"